This is one text. This is part of the Quran. I put it in my pocket so I can recite it any time that I have some time or I have empty time. The Quran was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in partial, based on events, based on things happening from time to time. Over 23 years that the Quran was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In these years, the Prophet was guiding the people to the Islam, was calling them to the Islam. All prophets before Muhammad, peace be upon him and peace be upon them all, have different miracles. All the miracles with the previous prophets were active in their times. Those miracles ended at those times. The miracle, the great miracle that Muhammad, peace be upon him, got is this Quran, the glorious, the holy Quran, because it's the guidance to the human being, the mankind, because it is in its authentic, original language, no change, no alterations. The other books, previous books, unfortunately, were tampered with. Many of them were changed, were replaced, different copies, different editions, translated into different languages, so they lost their original text. The Quran came in Arabic language, and when we talk about the translation of the Quran, we don't actually and shouldn't say translation of Quran, because when you read it, recite it in other language, it is not the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we say the translations of the meanings of the Quran, and we try to be as correct as possible, to be close to the meaning, to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This should be clear. And to see how great is this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that inna nahnu nazzalna al-Qur'ana wa inna lahu lahafidhun, meaning that we descended the Quran and we protected from changes, from forgetting. And look, millions and millions of people memorize, remember Quran by heart. And the strangest thing is most of those who remember Quran by heart are non-Arab. It's very strange. Either Pakistani, Indians, Malaysian, and so on. They are not Arab. They memorize over 600 pages of the Quran. Total pages of the Quran, over about 603 pages. They memorize it by heart. And sometimes when you meet one of those people, you want to speak with him, he cannot speak with you at all. But he remembers the Quran. He memorized the Quran. He can recite it from the cover to the cover. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قول يعني إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ولقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر. We have made this Quran easy for those who remember, for those who think of the other life. This Quran, ولقد إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم. This Quran guides to the right path, to the correct path, to the correct way that leads to the paradise, leads before that through the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that Allah be pleased with you. This is the Quran. When you talk about the scientific statements in the Quran, it has many verses that are unchangeable, and nobody can change any nobody can challenge unchangeable in verses in the Quran. It talks about the universe, it talks about many things. So the great miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is this Quran. He got many miracles. Some of the ulama, the scholars, said he got about over 1,000 miracles. But the main miracle is the Quran. It is easy to read, recite, remember. But the condition is that you come to it with clear heart. You come to it with an intention to understand it. It's guidance in the life. It's guidance for worshiping the correct worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's guidance for the relationship between the people. It's guidance for relationship within the family, within work area. This is the Quran. It is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I just wanted to deliver this message. There are stories in the Quran about the preceding generations when it was not revealed. Before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gets the Quran, nobody at that time was knowing about it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed those stories about previous nations to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This proves that the Quran is the only authentic book nowadays on the earth, and the Islam actually is the same origin for all our prophets. So we are supposed to follow this Quran, follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We as Muslims must believe in all prophets, not only Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we only believe in Muhammad and disbelieve in Jesus peace be upon him and Moses peace be upon him, we are not believers. If we have to believe in all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the original, the root of the religion is the same. Okay, of course, in the teachings there are differences, but as I mentioned again, I want to emphasize is that the Quran is in the original copy, is authentic. You cannot find any contradiction in the Quran. That's why the Quran, you can say sure without hesitance that this is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this, I conclude my speech. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.